Okay.
Anyway, did we mention that next week on the Jim Cornette Experience, Bertrand Hebert on Andre the Giant, we talked about that, and potentially the great Antonio, and this coming week on the Drive-Thru, which will be out this coming Monday, the normal day, we want suggestions. Not only will we answer the Cult of Cornette questions, the queries that have been sent in with bated breath. I hate queries with bated breath. But also, we're going to have a watch-along, and we want some suggestions. What classic match will put us in a good mood, will bring a smile to our faces, and also I can give some pithy comments to educate, illuminate, and elucidate the members of the Cult of Cornette on. Send some suggestions on Twitter between now and tomorrow, because then it'll be too late after that.
What are your preferences? What kind of stuff do you hope that we get to?
Well, I asked if that great Andre the Giant and Stan Hansen match from Japan was on YouTube, and you shot that one down. I figured that would go along with our interview next week with Bertrand. And I would love, so many people have said, well, Cornette, you ought to show us what you think is good wrestling with well-trained guys. The OVW catalog has some great matches, and the WWE sits on it, and you see something every once in a while, and it's generally not the real good stuff. It's just the stuff with Orton and Cena and Batista, but when they were green. But in my favorite OVW match of all time, probably, we did the whole show on this, was the Loser Leave Town match between Doug Basham and the Damager. And, you know, but I assume none of that stuff is on YouTube either. I haven't looked just because it's a WWE thing. But what would the folks like to see? That's what we want to know. Classic wrestling that would be widely available on YouTube or the Evil Empires Network that we can talk about.
One of these days, I would like us to do some stuff from the Chicago Wrestling Archive, like Lou Thesz versus Buddy Rogers.
Ooh, that would be cool also.
Yeah, because that stuff's great. And I think it would open a lot of people's eyes to what wrestling was in the 50s, that it may not be what you envisioned, as slow-paced as you thought it would be. But there was actually a lot of really great action-packed matches.
Well, yeah, and you also get a chance to see, especially with a guy like Rogers, you get a chance to see how spots started, how they were invented, what they first looked like, and what context they were used in, and how guys in the modern times have lost the context and just do things because they don't know how they were originated. You know, now when anybody drops down, like you're doing a crisscross back and forth across the ring with the other guy, and somebody drops down, the other guy just jumps right over them, and then they continue on. Why did the guy drop down? Well, it was one of two reasons. Either he dropped down to avoid something that the guy was doing coming at him, or he dropped down to try to cut the guy's legs out from under him as he was running. So when that spot was new back in the 50s, you would either see the guy lunge and the other guy drop, and the guy lunge and his momentum carried him over him and he hit the ropes on the other side, or you would see the guy try to cut the guy's legs out and the guy would jump over just in the nick of time and do the same thing. And now it's just, I'll drop down, you jump over. They don't know why. So those old matches are great for understanding why some of these things that you see in a lot of matches but don't necessarily make any fucking sense the way they're presented, how they made sense at the start. Does that make sense?
It makes sense. I mean, there's some good matches, too, from that era from Chicago. I think Carpentier and Thesz is up online. And, I mean, every big star from that era.
Well, now, Carpentier was not exactly on your all-time list of polished workers, but it was interesting to see the acrobatics at that point and how they could be integrated into an actual contest, because Thesz was going to brook, as he said in his autobiography, no foolishness.
Well, the other thing about that specific match is it's an NWA world title change, which led to Carpentier defending the title in various places, and then all of a sudden the NWA decided it wasn't a title change. But that led to the formation of the WWA.
Eddie Quinn. Lost his name for a second. Eddie Quinn, the promoter in Montreal, said, no, everybody in the country's not getting Carpentier. He's worth $1 million to me, and it wouldn't give him up.
But there's some great stuff there. Would you say that of the guys that were big stars in the 50s, that Buddy Rogers is the most influential in terms of the way guys would work in the next generation?
Yeah. Because, you know, there were a number of influential guys in the 50s and on national television. Obviously, nobody was going to work like Lou Thesz because he was already he was already in the 50s working in the style of the previous era. And he was unique in that respect. He was unique in every respect. Nobody was going to work like Gorgeous George because Gorgeous George was the gimmick. Vern Gagne was an NCAA champion. He primarily wrestled, and you know, there weren't a lot of those. Rogers was the first great worker who came up with the spots and the sequences, as he called them, and a lot of the movement and the working action. And I mean, everybody, all the bleach blonde guys in the 50s, from the Fargos to the Grahams, everybody was inspired by Buddy Rogers, to all the way to every bleach blonde heel ever in fucking wrestling, to everybody that ever begged off, or everybody that ever did a lot of high spots like fucking Flair or whatever. A lot of that started with Rogers, and the heelish interview didn't start with Rogers, but the strut and the whole fucking charismatic package kind of did. Anyway, that might be interesting too.
That's my vote for a future watch along. Fez versus Rogers from Chicago.
Well, let's see what the folks on Twitter have to say, and we will go with that over the next couple of days. Tune in on the drive-thru and find out.